Hi, hello, it's me again, Konrad from Racing Custom Parts. Today I would like to show you what we need to do to assembly adapter for MQ and DQ500 to VR6 R32 engines. Turn on subtitles and enjoy.
A popular modification, which is installing the MQ500 or DQ500 transmission onto VR6 R32 engines. As you know, these transmissions were never designed to fit these engines, but they are very durable and worth the modification. Since this is a popular modification, we have a one-piece adapter of our own design which allows the installation of DQ500 or MQ500 transmissions on R32, VR6, and R36 engines as well. However, these adapters require some machining of the transmission bell housing. This video is primarily for those who will perform the machining themselves in local shops equipped with CNC milling machines and similar capabilities. So, the key points are the reference points on the transmissions, both for the DQ500 and MQ500. We base the adapter on three centering points, this one, and this point. The adapter looks the same, it is based on these same three points. This is how it will look after machining. An important step is to make sure you lower these reference points before CNC machining, because after milling the transmission, these reference points will disappear and then you'll have a major issue fitting the adapter. So remember, these three points are crucial. Share this with your CNC specialists. All right, let's move on to the machining of the transmission. Abracadabra! Done. Just kidding, I did it earlier. Let me show you what the transmission should look like. The bell housing after proper machining. This point, this one, and this reference point were all deepened before lowering the entire transmission bell by 10 mm. It's important to lower the transmission bell surface by 10 mm because adding the adapter shouldn't change the height between the transmission and engine. This makes it easier to install various mounts, reinforcements, clutches, and flywheels. That's how it's done, and that's how you need to do it. If you just make holes for the adapter and raise the transmission by 10 mm, the starter ring won't work. So after machining, the transmission will look like this, the entire surface lowered by 10 mm, exactly the thickness of the adapter. It was milled here for the timing chain for our 32 engines, and the three reference points, first, second, and third. These are very important reference points, don't forget about them. At this spot, where the alignment pin is, you need to make an M10 thread, because you'll need it to secure the adapter. Alright, let's move on. Now we will install the adapter onto the transmission.
adapter.
So, the adapter should simply fit. And if necessary, you can tap it in gently to make sure it sits properly. Then, we can move on to bolting the adapter to the transmission. Quickly and easily bolt it on. I didn't bolt it on camera because it's awkward. You have to rotate the transmission. After bolting and machining, everything should simply fit. The bolts here are tightened from underneath. Here, we make a thread in the transmission. This thread is necessary, as you can see, to install the adapter. After all the machining and after bolting on the adapter, you can deepen the thread again. That previously ugly hole now fits perfectly with the alignment sleeve. You can run a tap deeper to make it easier to insert the bolt. I always do this for you, and that's how you get it from me. What's next? If you're doing this yourself, or having someone do it, before installing the adapter, first mount the bell housing to the transmission, then bolt the adapter on. It's because of this bolt here. This bolt won't fit through the adapter, it simply won't fit. So, if you receive a ready-made adapter from me, unfortunately, you'll have to remove it, mount the bell housing to the transmission, then reinstall the adapter again. I can't remove material here because the adapter's structure remains rigid only if the adapter is one solid piece. If I weaken it here, it will start to shift and move, and it will no longer serve its purpose, so unfortunately, it must stay like this. Now, with a DQ500 transmission, there's no issue. The starter can still be bolted on. However, with the MQ500 transmission, you lose the thread from the starter hole. I don't have an MQ500 transmission at the moment, but what I do is use a thread repair insert, known as a helical, in that hole. I glue the insert, so you get a solid thread for the starter. You'll just need to use a shorter bolt, but that's no problem. With the DSG DQ500 transmission, there's no such need, there's no such problem. In this area, the adapter might stick out a little due to stress, but the adapter will be bolted down after installing the transfer case, so this will be another element holding the adapter in place. And one more very important thing. You always receive adapters or transmissions with a sticker, dowels max 5mm. It's about the two dowels in the R32 engine block for centering the transmission. You need to shorten them, they must be a maximum of 5mm in height. This is very important because if you leave them as they are from the factory, which is about 6 to 7mm, the adapter won't sit properly. It won't lay on the engine as it should. The transmission will be mounted crooked. It's a very heavy transmission, you might not even notice it. If it's mounted crooked, you will damage the clutch, the flywheel, and possibly even the transmission. This could be very expensive, so remember, the dowels must be shortened. They should be a maximum of 5mm. In the place where the transmission is bolted to the engine, there's a floating hole here due to the fact that many of you have a reinforcing plate between the engine block and the oil pan. The oil pan then drops by 8, 9, or 10 millimeters, depending on where you got that plate. However, on the other side, the thread here remains only for engines with the plate. So, if you don't have a reinforcing plate under the engine, you can still bolt it down here. But in this spot, it's not possible. The issue is that if we raise it by 10 mm, the thread would be in this area, and the bolt would go into the alignment dowel. And this alignment dowel is a more important detail when it comes to aligning the transmission and the adapter on the transmission than this bolt in the oil pan. That's why, if you have a reinforcing plate under the engine, you have this thread. If you don't have the plate, unfortunately, you can't use it. That's a downside for some, but remember, it's just a bolt in the oil pan. I hope this video, as well as the older one on the channel, makes it easier for you to install and machine the transmission yourself, or for your local specialists to do it. I hope this one explains a bit more. I'll show you how it looks, it will make things even easier for you. Also, remember that the cost of modifying this bell housing at our place versus with local specialists will always be different. It will be much cheaper because we don't really make a profit on this machining. Often, it turned out that shipping the transmission both ways plus machining at our shop was cheaper than machining at a local company. So keep that in mind, because external companies have to spend time on it. They have to develop the project from scratch, they need to learn how to do it. For them it's not a simple job. They'll usually be doing it for the first time, so their price will be different than ours. I almost forgot about the extras. Remember, we also have different versions of flywheels available on our website. For example, here I have a Stage 3 flywheel ready for an order. The only difference between Stage 3 and Stage 4 is the weight. This flywheel is simply heavier. You can choose according to your preference, based on your tuner's recommendations, the person tuning your transmission, engine, computers, and so on. Some people prefer a lighter flywheel, others a heavier one. We also have cheaper, lower versions, more suitable for street use. However, they transmit less power things like launch procedures and similar stuff. That's why we developed the Stage 3 and Stage 4 flywheels, so they can be used in motorsports. With the DQ500 and MQ500 gearbox adapter set for the R32 engine, it's worth getting a mount for the transfer case. If you don't have our reinforcement or don't want to order it, you can order such an adapter from us as well. It will hold the transfer case on the R32 engine. And since the transmission is disassembled anyway, and you're probably reprogramming it, we also have aluminum mechatronic sleeves with O-rings, brand new. You can replace them during the whole modification. So, mounting, transfer adapter, mechatronic sleeves, and an adapter for the shift cable from the DQ250 gearbox. If you have an Audi TT RS, R32, or similar cars, where you have a DQ250 gearbox with a shift lever and the whole system, but you're upgrading to the stronger DQ500 gearbox, you can keep that shift lever and use this adapter to shift gears in the DQ500 gearbox. All right, I think that's everything I wanted to say about machining this transmission, about the DQ500 and MQ500 adapters, and other parts. We have a few more parts available on the website, but not all are ready, and I don't remember all of them while recording this video. But if you go to the parts catalog on our site and type DQ500, then a full list of parts we have for this transmission will appear. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being here. Thank you for ordering parts. There's not a week that goes by without a transmission leaving here, and for that, I'm truly grateful. I invite anyone who's still undecided. Thank you for watching the video. Take care. I wish you trouble-free driving and as much power as you dream of. Bye.